Hello, I'm Gunjan Saxena. I'm going to be taking this course on international commercial arbitration. So, beginning with introduction to arbitration. So, what exactly is arbitration? So, the problem with the definition of arbitration is that it is in the model law, it is not defined. Now, before we get into the dynamics of the definition and how do you interpret it, we need to understand that it is really important for us to interpret the word well, right? So, beginning with that, we need to understand that, you know, the exact wording, meaning of the word arbitration has been explained as in the Oxford English Dictionary is called as uncontrolled decision. Now, however negative that you know, the effect of that word is, that's the exact meaning of the word, an uncontrolled decision. However, when you look at it from a law and the arbitration, international commercial arbitration perspective, things change slightly. So let's look at the different interpretation of this meaning. So it's primarily, according to the Oxford Dictionary, English Dictionary, the settlement of a question at issue by one to whom the parties agree to refer their claims in order to obtain an equitable decision. So primarily the definition is telling you that it's the parties who decide. It's the parties who decide who and how the dispute would be settled. So this is the exact interpretation which will around which we will revolve our whole reading. The DMOCS commercial arbitration defines the international arbitration process by, as one by which parties voluntarily refer their disputes to an impartial third person, an arbitrator, who is selected by them for a decision which is based on the evidence and arguments to be presented before the arbitration tribunal, and the parties agree in advance that the arbitrator's determination of the award will be accepted as the final and binding award upon them. Now, what does this definition do? So, the DMOCS commercial arbitration definition clearly tells you the essentials of what will constitute arbitration. Let's go back to the definition and read it. So, arbitration is a process by which parties voluntarily refer. First essential, that the party's autonomy or the party's decision is voluntary in nature, that the parties have agreed to enter into an arbitral agreement or to refer their disputes to arbitration. They have voluntarily agreed to refer their disputes to an impartial third person. The second essential is that there has to be an existing impartial third person to whom the dispute would be referred. Now, an arbitrator has to be selected by them. This is the third essential, that the arbitrator who is impartial has to be selected by the parties themselves. Now, there are various processes in which selection of arbitrators takes place, and selection of arbitrators is primarily based on what the parties have agreed, right? So, a decision based on the evidence and arguments. Now, this is the next bit, the fourth essential, that the evidences and the arguments will be put forth before the tribunal, before a third impartial authority or impartial arbitrator by the parties themselves. So, the parties will be going forward to put their arguments and their evidences in favor of their cause, and the impartial arbitrator will be taking a decision on it. Now, which will be presented before the arbitral tribunal, and An arbitral tribunal could be a panel of arbitrators or a sole arbitrator. We will delve into the dynamics of what is the selection process, how many should be there. We will deal with the number of panel of arbitrators and whether a sole arbitrator is allowed or not. Now, another essential is that the parties have to agree in advance. So, the parties, while they are entering into an agreement, they have to, while they are entering, so for example, you presume that there are two MNCs who are working in India, and they want to enter into an agreement to, for example, sale of technology or, you know, sale of goods or anything to that matter. And they enter into this agreement. Now, in this very agreement, it has to be indicated that they want to refer the disputes that arise out of this agreement to arbitration. So, the arbitrator's determination of the award will be based on the fact that he has the jurisdiction or he has the authority to look at the disputes. The parties have to agree in advance for an arbitration, and that the arbitrator's determination on the dispute is considered as the final and the binding factor. Now, in this, what is important for us to understand is these are the last two essentials of our basic definition or of arbitration or what constitutes arbitration. So, first thing, you have to agree in advance. Your agreement in itself should contain an intention to arbitrate. And the second part is that while you have put forth the disputes before your arbitrator, and you have as parties or as arbitrators, you know, heard the disputes, or as parties brought forth the disputes before the panel of arbitrators, you need to understand that the determination that is made by the panel of arbitrators or the sole arbitrator is final and binding. We will understand the dynamics of what constitutes as final award, primarily because the wording final arbitral award might not mean the same. There are certain exceptions, certain rules that are involved in the whole scenario. Now, another interesting definition is by David's Arbitration in International Trade. And after we've understood what constitutes an arbitration, let's also look at this definition. So, according to this definition, arbitration is a device whereby the settlement of a question which is of interest for two or more parties who derive their powers from a private agreement, not from the authorities of a state. This is primarily important in this definition to understand. So, the powers that are derived in an arbitration are based on the agreement that has been rendered between the parties, the agreement that has been made between the parties, right? And to the derivation of this power from a private agreement is essential. It should not be from the authority of a state, and those who derive their powers from a private agreement are to proceed and decide the case on the basis of such an agreement itself, right? So, the merits of your dispute will be based on the agreement, the merits of the fact that whether this dispute can be referred to arbitration will be based on the agreement that you have entered into as parties. So, this is an interesting interpretation and one of the most highlighted parts of this definition is the fact that it says that party autonomy, the intention of the parties to contract or to agree to enter into an arbitration is paramount in case of arbitration, and the authority comes from within that very agreement, does not come from the authorities of the state. Now, obviously, there might be certain questions arising in your mind as to how can you outlaw the state's law. So let's look at the dynamics of how this works further.